October 2019. So this October 2019, Kurukshetra, which is on the agricultural reforms, you will get very good content, right? And also UPSC follows this source, right? So UPSC actually takes the topic from this area, right? So in the examination hall also you will get the same question. Karthikeyan is asking, though after getting adequate facts it is quite difficult to use it in answers at appropriate places, how to develop such a skill? And no, we used it rightly. Great, very good question. So my friend, I will in this particular series only I will have 2-3 sessions on the mains answer writing also, mains answer writing of GS3 also, and other areas also. I will have sessions about how to cover the current affairs, and I will cover certain current affairs issues also, right? So there you will definitely find the answer to your question. But let me give you quick answer right now, my friend. In each and every topic you might have unlimited number of points. You might have 10 point, 15 point. For getting the maximum marks, you are not supposed to write all the point in the examination. If you write just 4 point, 5 point, and each of those point is unique, each of those point is substantiated with proper facts or examples, then nothing like that. I'm coming to that point only. You should give lot of practical examples. For example, if you are giving the answer of environmental impact assessment, you should give the example how the power plants are misusing the fly ash regulations, how they are spreading the fly ash on the roads, how this environmental impact assessment is being violated on the ground, right? You should give the example of Vedanta and other industries. Similarly, in case of agriculture, you can give the models of PDS from different state, the model of Karnataka, Chhattisgarh. Similarly, in the other areas you can give the example of development. So I am not saying you need to write 10 point, write 4-5 point, but each of those points should be substantiated with some example, some fact, and those points should be unique and different from each other, right? For example, if we talk about what are the adverse impact of inequality, what are the adverse impact of inequality, you should see what is the impact on the environment, that poor people are over exploiting environment because they are dependent on the environment, they don't have any other source. The rich people are exploiting the environment because they are having extra resources, so they do not care about the exploitation, right? So inequality, both rich and poor, both are actually burdening the environment. So this is the environmental point. About the internal security, because of this inequality, the problem of nationalism and extremism became much more extreme in India, right? So you can give the dimension of the inequality in the internal security, right? Then similarly, this inequality problem in the disaster, right? In the disaster, so for example, in the time of corona, because of this inequality, there are a lot of migrant poor people who are not able to get 2 times food, right? There are homeless children, they are homeless children who are not able to get 2 times food. So you can give the example from the recent time and linking with the some dimension, right? Similarly, other areas also you can see, right? So when I'm discussing what are the adverse impact of the inequality, I will not say impact only on the economy, but what are the impacts on the environment, what are the impacts on the internal security, what are the impacts on the bilateral relations, what are the impact while we are managing the disaster. So this is what I mean by the unique point. जब मैं यूनिक पॉइंट की बात करता हूं तो मैं कहता हूं कि आपका हर एक पॉइंट अपने आप में एक सबस्टेंशियबल पॉइंट होना चाहिए विद प्रॉपर एग्जांपल. कार्तिकेयन, डिड यू गेट द आंसर? सो दिस इज अ ब्रीफ आंसर विच आई गेव टू यू, a small example, but I will bring a lot of other issues and the answer in the upcoming session. चलिए तो आगे बढ़ते हैं. गवर्नमेंट स्कीम्स डेफिनेटली दे आर बिकमिंग वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. वी विल सी हाउ मोर एंड मोर गवर्नमेंट स्कीम्स आर बीइंग आस्क्ड रिसेंटली, राइट. एक्ट्स, बिल्स, बॉडीज, डायग्राम्स, वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. फ्रेंड्स, इफ यू सी इन द एग्जामिनेशन हॉल यू विल फाइंड टू टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चंस, राइट. 15 मार्कर, 10 मार्कर. फॉर द 10 मार्कर यू विल गेट टू पेजेस, फॉर द 15 मार्कर यू विल गेट 3 pages, ठीक है. You will have lot of data facts, जैसे कार्तिकेय ने बोला कि सर facts बहुत ज्यादा हो जाते हैं. At this time you should utilize this diagram. आपको diagram use करना चाहिए. You can use the web diagram, matrix diagram, right? Different type of diagrams you can use to give lot of points, ठीक है. तो you can give more number of point also if you have good points. And definitely, those point if you give in the diagram, the space occupied will be less, and you will be able to save your time also. ठीक है, तो time भी आपका save होगा और आपका space भी save होगा. So Shivam is asking, sir, you said you have covered these things in your class notes. Can we get those notes in the PDF format? Yes. So. All of these notes are available in the PDF format, but those are available for the classroom students only as of now, right? So I will discuss many of those topic in the upcoming sessions, which will be free, so that you also get to know how to prepare, right? So you can prepare on your own yourself also, right? Clear. Now coming to the each and every area. अब हम बात करते हैं हर एक area की. राइट, अब हम एरिया की बात करते हैं. तो मैक्रो इकोनॉमी की बात करें, इन द मैक्रो इकोनॉमी इफ यू सी द सिलेबस, इन द सिलेबस यू विल हैव द क्वेश्चंस ऑन प्लानिंग. तो व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द नीति आयोग एंड द प्लानिंग कमीशन, दैट क्वेश्चन वाज आस्क्ड इन 2018. मोबिलाइजेशन ऑफ रिसोर्सेज, राइट. सो सेविंग्स एंड इन्वेस्टमेंट रेट, all these type of questions are asked here. Growth, development, employment, in the employment the questions about jobless growth, the questions about whether India's youth is capable, questions about demographic dividend, right. Inclusive growth, this is a very very favorite area. Every alternate year you will get one question, right. Every alternate year you will get one question from the inclusive growth. On the inclusive growth I have already put one YouTube session. You can attend that session, and in just 1 hour you will get mastery over the inclusive growth, and you will also get idea how to prepare the topic in the 360 degree manner. So go to the YouTube and do the and search by the topic of inclusive growth. In the top you will find my lecture. So YouTube search jab aap karenge इंक्लूसिव ग्रोथ के नाम से, टॉप में मेरा लेक्चर आपको दिखेगा. टेक 1 hour एंड कंप्लीट दिस टॉपिक फ्रॉम देयर. यू विल गेट एन आइडिया हाउ टू ब्रिंग यूनिक पॉइंट्स, हाउ टू ब्रिंग एग्जांपल्स, हाउ टू ब्रिंग गवर्नमेंट स्कीम्स, हाउ टू ब्रिंग फैक्ट्स एट सिंगल प्लेस इन द मिनिमम पॉसिबल टाइम. ठीक है, गवर्नमेंट बजटिंग इज बिकमिंग वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. आई विल शो यू दैट देयर आर वेरियस क्वेश्चंस कमिंग फ्रॉम दिस बजटिंग एरिया. इफेक्ट्स ऑफ लिबरलाइजेशन, वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. इंडस्ट्रियल पॉलिसी about manufacturing, industrial revolution 4.0, draft industrial revolution policy 2017, all these things were there. Okay, so great. Am I audible to everyone? Couple of you are saying I'm not audible. Great. So, sir, is your notes available on Telegram also? On Telegram, the notes may be available. I think last year, but I will put some of the notes in the Telegram also, right? So I will try to put at least 2-3 topic every week so that you can also get an idea how to prepare GS3. ठीक है? तो मैं कोशिश करूंगा कुछ आपको फ्री टॉपिक भी मैं प्रोवाइड करता रहूं, हफ्ते में 2-3 टॉपिक मैं प्रोवाइड करने की कोशिश करूंगा. ठीक है, चलिए. देन इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. बट सरप्राइजिंगली इन 2019 देयर वाज नो क्वेश्चन ऑन इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर. ये बहुत ही सरप्राइजिंग बात है. ठीक है, सरप्राइजिंगली देयर वाज नो क्वेश्चन ऑन द इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर इन 2019, बट इट इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. राइट, वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. You will find at least one question, at least one question. Investment models, public-private partnerships, right? This is again important. Now you can see 2019 questions. When then if we see 2019 questions, we will find different type of questions. हम देख सकते हैं कि सभी तरह के questions आए हैं. All type of questions have been asked. Question number one, it is about the GST. GST is a very favorite area of the UPSC, and this was quite in news. So this is one of the very easy question, easy and direct question, right? Do you agree with the view that steady GDP growth and low inflation have left the Indian economy in good shape? Give reasons for your supports. This question was little bit difficult, I will say, not a direct question. So you can write the answer to such questions from the Hindu and even from the economic survey, right? Even from the economic survey. ठीक है, economic survey के में भी if we see last year economic survey focused on $5 trillion economy. ठीक है, $5 billion. Sorry, am I audible? Hello, am I audible? Okay, great. So from the economic survey also you can give the answer to such type of question. Inclusive growth, I already told you, favorite area of UPSC, and they have again asked this question. Public expenditure management, this was in news. So there was a news about public debt management office, PDMA. That is why this question was in the news. Coming to the agriculture, this area is also very important, and nowadays the government schemes are being asked in this area, right? If we see the syllabus ke andar aap dekh sakte ho cropping pattern, there are questions on the cropping pattern. There are different types of irrigation and irrigation systems, transport, marketing, e-technology. So questions are being asked on all of these areas. Irrigation ke upar bhi question pucha ja raha hai, मार्केटिंग के ऊपर भी क्वेश्चंस पूछा जा रहा है, एपीएमसी, राइट. कमिंग टू द सब्सिडी, पॉवर्टी एलिवेशन, एग्रीकल्चर टेक्नोलॉजी, द क्वेश्चन अबाउट द सब्सिडी, एमएसपी, यस, द क्वेश्चन आर बीइंग आस्क्ड ऑन दीज एरियाज. पीडीएस, पब्लिक डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन सिस्टम, द क्वेश्चन वाज आस्क्ड इन 2019 आल्सो, राइट. बफर स्टॉक, फूड सिक्योरिटी, टेक्नोलॉजी मिशन, इकोनॉमिक्स ऑफ एनिमल रियरिंग, अगेन दिस इज ऑल्सो इंपॉर्टेंट. फूड प्रोसेसिंग, द क्वेश्चन वाज आस्क्ड इन 2019 आल्सो. सो the questions are coming from all these areas. Each and every topic is important in the agriculture, right? If you see 2019 paper, the question was about integrated farming, right? In 2018, the question was on organic farming. So you should also know about different kind of farming. For example, precision farming, satellite farming, right? You should know about those kind of different farming system, because new farming system are being asked in the examination. Elaborate the impact of national watershed project. This is a question from the government scheme, right? So nowadays the government schemes are being asked. Aajkal government scheme puche ja rahe hain. So you can see even this food grain distribution topic, this was about the reformative steps, that is different policies. For example, DBT, for example, PDS reforms, right? Policy taken by the government regarding the food processing sector, that is PM Sampada Yojana, right? So you can see most of the questions are being asked from the government schemes, right? Coming to the internal security, the internal security, if we see the key areas of internal security, mostly almost every year the questions are coming from the cyber security, social media. Every year in the last 7 years, like 7 years, every year there is a question on cyber security. So in 2019 it was about cyber dome. Before that it was about BN Sri Krishna committee. Before that it was about cyber attacks, cyber security policy. Before that it was non-state actor. Usse pehle ye cyber warfare ke bare mein tha. Har saal, every year, the questions are there on cyber security and social media. Cyber security or social media pe questions aa rahe hain. Number two, nationalism and extremism, again very very important. Every year minimum one question from this area. So in 2019 there was a question on UAPA, on Jamaat Islami, right? In 2018 there was a question on left wing extremism, northeast extremism, surgical strike, right? Border security management is also another area. So we see the questions on Myanmar border, CPEC, border challenges, illegal migration, right? So we can see all these areas are being asked in detail. So three primary areas: cyber security and social media, nationalism and extremism, and border security. These are the three primary areas for the internal security. ठीक है, ये तीन primary area है internal security के लिए. So what is the source for internal security, my friend? For internal security, you should follow the current affair. In addition to that, you read any textbook. कोई भी textbook पढ़ लो. There are lot of textbook available in the market. Follow only one textbook, but the problem is that those textbook are not giving examination oriented matter. And they are being written by the IPS officers, but very unfortunately, many a time you will not find very good point for the examination, right? So for that you need to do your own research. Aapko thodi research karne ki zarurat hai, from the Hindu, from maybe Indian Express, from IDSA, theek hai? To aapko kuch kuch aapko research karne ki zarurat hai. Waise agar aap dekhte ho to सेकेंड ईयर से भी कुछ रिपोर्ट्स फॉलो कर सकते हो. इन द सेकेंड ईयर सी देयर इज अ डिस्कशन अबाउट दिस टेररिज्म, लेफ्ट विंग एक्सट्रीमिज्म. सो यू विल गेट वेरी गुड पॉइंट्स फ्रॉम द सेकेंड ईयर सी ऑल्सो. आईडीएससी वेबसाइट, इट गिव्स द पॉइंट अबाउट क्रॉस बॉर्डर टेररिज्म, बॉर्डर मैनेजमेंट, रिलेशंस बिटवीन द नेबरिंग कंट्रीज, ऑल दीज एरियाज, राइट? इन द इंटरनल सिक्योरिटी आई हैव अ सजेशन. इन द इंटरनल सिक्योरिटी आई हैव अ सजेशन, यू शुड मेक एटलीस्ट वन मैप. For example, map of the terrorism, map of the left-wing extremism, right? For, map about the northeast internal security. That will give you an edge. And definitely, should give a lot of current examples in your answers. ठीक है? If we see 2019 paper, 2019 का जो paper है, in the 2019, there was a question about Jamaat-e-Islami, banning of Jamaat-e-Islami about overground workers, right? So, although this was in news, but not highly in news, right? So, I definitely agree that not everything will be covered in the Hindu. So, we can refer to other sources like IDSA for the environment. We can refer to Down to Earth for the economy and agriculture. We can refer to this Live Mint, है ना? तो आपको और sources भी refer करनी पड़ सकती हैं, है ना? तो what is the best way to do the research on the GS3 topic? आपको क्या करना है? Just write the name of the topic in the Google, right? Google में topic का नाम लिखो और जो भी top 5 sources हैं, आप उनको follow कर सकते हो, है ना? या फिर अगर आपको Live Mint से वो search करना है, write the name of the topic and write Live Mint along with that. For example, Inclusive Growth, Live Mint. तो आपको Live Mint से जो अच्छे points होंगे वो मिल जाएंगे. उसी तरह से Terrorism, IDSA. तो IDSA की website पे जो Terrorism के point होंगे वो आपको मिल जाएंगे. तो in this manner, you can get lot of good point from the good websites. ठीक है? तो आपको थोड़ा सा research करना पड़ सकता है. ठीक है? वैसे ये सब research I have already done from my classroom students. वो सब मैंने research की हुई है. आप उसका advantage ले सकते हो. You can take the advantage of that research which I have done from all the topics. ठीक है? चलिए आते हैं. What is Cyberdome project? ये Cyberdome project क्या है? This was the question. So this is the project of the Kerala government, right? So this is one of the question which I will say not very very easy, but it is easy only if you know about this project. तो हम लोग क्या करते हैं कि जब हम GS3 में पढ़ रहे होते हैं तो हम लोग छोटे छोटे टॉपिक की तरफ हम ज्यादा नहीं जाते हैं. वी आर ट्राइंग टू कवर द मैक्रो टॉपिक्स, राइट? बट नाउ द पैटर्न इज इंडिकेटिंग दैट वी शुड नो एटलीस्ट 50 to 100 वर्ड्स अबाउट द स्मॉल टॉपिक्स ऑल्सो. तो जो छोटे छोटे टॉपिक्स हैं उसके बारे में भी हमें 50 to 100 टॉपिक्स को जानना जरूरी है. वी शुड नो 50 to 100 words about the small topics also, right? In the science and technology, in the internal security, these small topic will give you certain matter which you can write in the examination if there is a question. ठीक है? So in such type of question, we cannot say that we will be able to score 80%, 90%, you know, 60%, 70% marks. But at least we can say, ओके, वी विल स्कोर 20% 30% मार्क्स. ठीक है? तो जो इस तरह के प्रोजेक्ट जो टॉपिक्स है उसको हम लोग गारंटी नहीं ले सकते कि बहुत अच्छे से कवर कर पाएंगे खुद से भी, लेकिन कम से कम एग्जाम में हमारा क्वेश्चन ना छूटे इन एरिया से, हमें कोशिश ऐसी करनी चाहिए. देन देयर वाज अ क्वेश्चन अबाउट अमेंडमेंट ऑफ यूआपा. अगेन दिस वाज अ क्वेश्चन अबाउट टेररिज्म ओनली. ठीक है? क्रॉस बॉर्डर के बारे में क्वेश्चन था, राइट? So as I already told you, three areas: cyber security, terrorism, and cross-border management. These three areas are very very important for the internal security. If there is any news in the current affair, you should not leave that news in any manner. Okay, ji. That was about internal security. Now let us come to the environment. In the environment, three areas are important. One is the climate change, right? So about the climate change, you already have a lot of good resources. You can follow the Shankar IAS for the basics, right? Then you can refer to the government schemes on the climate change, sustainable development goals, right? Then even in the economic survey also, this topic is covered beautifully. Right, sustainable development is another area, and pollution. This is another area: air pollution, water pollution. Every year you will find one question on these areas. Pollution के ऊपर आपको हर question मिलता ही मिलता है normally. ठीक है? If not every year, at least you know every 2 years आपको alternate year में question मिलेगा ही मिलेगा pollution के ऊपर. ठीक है? बहुत important question area है. Environment के लिए आपके पास में Shankar IAS को follow कर सकते हो. इकोनॉमिक सर्वे को आप फॉलो कर सकते हो. इसके अलावा जो स्ट्रेटजी डॉक्यूमेंट है नीति आयोग का, इसके अंदर भी एक चैप्टर है, देयर इज अ वन चैप्टर ऑन द इन द नीति आयोग स्ट्रेटजी डॉक्यूमेंट, यू कैन फॉलो दैट सोर्स ऑल्सो, ठीक है. देन देयर इज अ नीति आयोग एजेंडा, 3 year agenda, you can follow this 3 year agenda of Niti Aayog also. ये भी बहुत अच्छा मतलब दिया हुआ है. This is also given in a very beautiful manner. You can follow this also. ठीक है. So there is a one chapter on environment in the 3 year agenda and in the strategy document of Niti Aayog. ठीक है. My friend, we have to see the governance part. We have to see the governance part of the environment in the GS3. ठीक है. GS3 के अंदर हमें governance part को फोकस करना होता है. ठीक है. इफ यू प्रिपेयर ऑल दिस, यू आर एक्चुअली प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर द एसे पेपर ऑल्सो. आपका जो एसे पेपर होता है उसमें भी आपकी बहुत सारी तैयारी हो जाती है, बिकॉज इन द एसे ऑल्सो यू फाइंड द टॉपिक्स लाइक एनवायरमेंट वर्सेस डेवलपमेंट. ठीक है. तो इस तरह के टॉपिक आपको एसे के अंदर भी मिलते हैं. तो आपको इस तरह के जो जो टॉपिक्स हैं वो आपको बहुत अच्छे से प्रिपेयर करने चाहिए विद लॉट ऑफ एग्जाम्पल्स. Keep collecting the example from the Hindu newspaper. Hindu से आपको example लेने चाहिए. ठीक है. If we see 2019, 25 marks question were asked. 10 marker of coastal sand mining and 15 marker of the carrying capacity. This carrying capacity question was from NCERT. 11th. Indian Economic Development. So as I told you, NCERT is very very important, not only for economy but other areas also, right? If you have good grip over the NCERT, then definitely you get an edge. Aapko edge milti hi milti hai. This question number 17 is directly from the NCERT. There are other things you should keep in mind in the environment. You can always quote the United Nations report, UNEP report. You can quote various indexes, Sustainable Livelihood Index, SDG, all those indexes. Facts, definitely. Science and technology. The last area is the science and technology, right? In the science and technology, if we see 2019 paper, they have been asking about the contributions of different scientists. ठीक है. Now these questions are very very specific. ठीक है. बहुत specific है. These questions are not very very easy. But if you make a list of important scientists in the last 100 years, then you can definitely write their contribution also. India's development in the science and technology, that is the area which is focused in the mains examination. So this topic of having our own space station was also asked in 2019. Then the question on the traditional knowledge, the protection of traditional knowledge. So this is the question on the intellectual property right. Biotechnology, right? So if we see the key areas of the science and technology, agar hum important areas ki baat karein, important areas are biotechnology, intellectual property rights, right? So on the biotechnology, the questions about the impact of biotechnology on the farmers, biopharma, stem cells, and lot many other questions have been asked on the biotechnology in the last 6-7 years. Intellectual property rights, especially about the patents. Every alternative year, there is a question. There is one question about the patents. Then achievements of the Indians and in India's science and technology development. So question about Swaminathan, Bose, Einstein, space station, unmanned space station, fast breeder reactors, standard positioning system. All these questions are being asked in the last 6-7 years. So every year you will find some of the questions from the achievements of India's science and technology sector. My friends, are you getting what I'm saying? Are you enjoying the session? Say yes. Are you getting the value from the session? Are you learning some new things? Okay, great. Wonderful. Chaliye. तो GS3 बहुत बड़ा है यार, इट इज वेरी वेरी बिग, है ना, एट द सेम टाइम इट इज वेरी वेरी स्कोरिंग, ठीक है। नाउ यू विल फाइंड बोथ so sir I find the concepts covered in Hindu newspaper for GS3 is very especially economy for the agriculture. I agree my friend, that is why I am saying you focus on the static portion, syllabus pe focus karo. For example, you should have very good material on the food processing, very good material on the inclusive growth. Then from the current affair you can give some examples to add on to that. Usko add on karne ke liye kuch example de sakte ho. Your sources for primary preparation should be economic survey, Niti Aayog strategy document, NCERT, and the basic topics of the syllabus. ठीक है, तो syllabus को ध्यान में रखते हुए you should refer to the economic survey, Niti Aayog strategy document, NCERT, and one standard book. ठीक है, तो आप इसको फॉलो करो एंड डू योर ऑन रिसर्च। द करंट अफेयर इज जस्ट फॉर एडिंग सम फैक्ट्स और सम एग्जांपल्स। करंट अफेयर को आप प्राइमरी सोर्स ऑफ प्रिपरेशन मत बनाओ। डू नॉट मेक द करंट अफेयर्स एज अ प्राइमरी सोर्स ऑफ प्रिपरेशन। इट शुड बी रेफर टू एज ओनली टू गेट टू नो विच एरियाज आर इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर दिस ईयर एग्जामिनेशन। प्लस यू कैन टेक सम एग्जाम्पल्स, प्लस यू कैन टेक सम facts, data, and you can write something about government initiatives which have been taken in the last 6 months or 1 year. So, sirf aur sirf aapko itna hi janne ki zarurat hai current affairs se. GS3 is not equal to current affairs. I have said this many times. You should utilize the current affairs to add on to your answers, not as a primary source. ठीक है? Sir, please provide this video after the class at this gallery or at Telegram. Which video you are asking, my friend? Are you asking about the inclusive growth or which video? I think you are asking about the inclusive growth. Okay, I will give you the link of inclusive growth in the Telegram. Not an issue. Great. चलिए. So, in the science and technology, you will find both type of question, open-ended question and analytical question. ठीक है, आपको दोनों ही तरह के questions मिलेंगे, open-ended and analytical. Shivam is saying, can we get this session's video in Telegram? Okay, I will upload, but give me some time, give me couple of days. ठीक है, meanwhile you should schedule yourself for 3:30 PM daily. So we will have 1 hour to 1.5 hour daily, ठीक है, about GS3 current affairs, about GS2, about mains answer writing, ठीक है, so just spend 1 hour, 1.5 hour on the mains area, and you will definitely get an edge in your preparation. That is my promise. तो आप सिर्फ, you just take out 7-8 days, right, and you can get the benefit of these sessions, and definitely I will upload the video, but not immediately, I will need some time because I myself need to edit these videos, then only I can upload. Chaliye, theek hai. Range and extremely covered, range is very very big, hai na, range of science and technology very very big, like there can be 100 topics of the science and technology, hai na, 100 topics ho sakte hain, right? So science and technology mein hum log bahut zyada deep mein nahi ja sakte, we cannot go much into deep, but we should keep track of the recent current affair. तो साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी के लिए आपको क्या करना है, आई विल गिव यू सम स्टैटिक फोल्डर मटेरियल फॉर द साइंस एंड टेक, एनालिटिकल फोल्डर मटेरियल अबाउट बायोटेक्नोलॉजी, अबाउट नैनो टेक्नोलॉजी, अबाउट स्पेस, अबाउट कंप्यूटर साइंस, अबाउट डिफेंस, अबाउट न्यूक्लियर. सो आई विल गिव यू एनालिटिकल सब्जेक्ट मैटर, एनालिटिकल स्टडी मटेरियल ऑन द साइंस एंड टेक. ठीक है, आप उसको अच्छे से पढ़ो, कीप द स्टैटिक पोर्शन रेडी, एंड इन द लास्ट मंथ just before the mains examination you update yourself with the current affairs. That is how you can get mastery in the science and tech. There is no other way. You do not you're not supposed to devote daily 1 hour on the science and tech. आपको daily 1 hour spend करने की जरूरत नहीं है. Even if you focus on the static portion and update yourself in the last month of the mains, then only it will be useful. ठीक है. Science reporter is one area which can be helpful. Now coming to the disaster management. Okay. So in the disaster management, now the questions are not, coming very, 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 broad questions, but now questions are coming from micro areas. Okay. Micro areas se questions aa rahe hain. Now they are not asking about disaster management cycle. Rather, they are asking about the hazard zone mapping. They are asking about vulnerability. So we need to get little bit deeper into the disaster management. Every year we get minimum one question. In 2019 we get two question, one and two. 2019 mein do question aaye the. In 2020 also there is a chance that you will get two questions. You will get two questions because this whole situation of corona is a disaster situation, right? This is under the Disaster Management Act only. Therefore, you should follow Disaster Management Act and the current affairs news very, very properly. For the disaster management, there are three important sources which you can follow. NDMA guidelines. So National Disaster Management Authority has given the guidelines on how to manage the earthquake, how to manage the cyclones, tsunami, everything, urban floods. On each and every aspect, they haven't given the guideline. Even UPSC is asking these guidelines, right? Directly. What are the guidelines on the earthquake? What are the guidelines on the urban floods? So you should understand these guidelines. And I have already included all these guidelines in all the topics in my notes. Second ARC, in the second ARC, there is one report about the crisis management, right? So here you will get some good ideas, some good fodder material about the second ARC. Then Sendai framework you should follow. Then there are some YouTube sessions which you will find about the previous year questions trained. The link of the inclusive growth I have given in this session, right? There are some other topics which have been given, right? I am offering complete course on the GS3 mains where I am covering all the areas: economy, agriculture, environment, science and tech, internal security. There are 350 plus topics which includes videos, PDF note. And I will be taking the live sessions on live platform, and you will also be getting the recording of all these live sessions in the sessions. ठीक है. I'm also giving you the mind maps, exam time synopsis. So you should have the exam time synopsis with you. ठीक है. आपके पास में exam time synopsis भी होना चाहिए, where on single page you are having the crux of 3-4 topics. ठीक है. एक ही पेज के अंदर आपको 3-4 टॉपिक का क्रक्स मिल जाए. ठीक है. लेट मी शो यू द एग्जाम टाइम क्रक्स फ्रॉम माय ओन नोट्स. सो आर यू इंटरेस्टेड टू सी हाउ टू मेक द क्रक्स नोट्स? आर यू इंटरेस्टेड? से यस इफ यू आर इंटरेस्टेड. आई कैन शेयर विद यू ऑन, फॉर एग्जांपल, ऑन द जेंडर बजटिंग. व्हाट इज जेंडर बजटिंग, राइट? व्हाट इज द नेसेसिटी ऑफ जेंडर बजटिंग? What are the benefits? So you will see, like, there are unique points written over here. Benefits: gives way to gender sensitive fiscal policies, improves women's economic equality, then linking with the sustainable development goal, right? Transparency, accountability, gender sensitive programs, issues. You can see this separate point, right? So if you make such notes, you will be able to revise. Then points from the budget 2019. So all these points: increasing women's enterprise, women self-help group interest subvention, Jandhan account, one woman in every self-help group eligible, right? About on all the topic, you can prepare your own notes, right? Current affair, all these notes are from the current affairs, right? The topics like digital infrastructure, right? Digital India, right? national policy on software, national digital policy, policy on electronics, horticulture. You can see Ashok Dalwai committee, Niti Aayog recommendation. So this is how you can make your notes. Insolvency code, economic survey requirements, right? So you should prepare your notes in a way where you can use the different authentic sources. जहाँ पर आप authentic sources को mention कर सको, ठीक है? So all these, like this analysis of the Saubhagya Yojana, right? Complete analysis. What is the need, features, benefits, challenges, way forward, right? Special economic zone, right? WTO reforms. All these areas are very, very important, and you should actually follow a comprehensive approach, right? So exam time synopsis. This is called exam time synopsis. See, my friends, in the examination, if you are able to recall all the important point of a particular topic, then automatically you can increase your score. आप अपना score बढ़ा सकते हो. ठीक है. So you might be having lot of material with yourself, but if you are not able to utilize that material on the examination day, then it is of no use. ये आपके किसी काम का नहीं है. ठीक है. So you should always try to make the exam time synopsis, and you should keep writing the answers, right? You should keep writing the answers. So all these facilities are available in my paid course. In the next 7-8 days, I will try to cover some of the areas from that course, so you can take the advantage, right? Then in the upcoming days, I'm coming up with the GS2 mains complete course, and I will also share with you complete analysis of the 2019 paper and the GS2 strategy for the mains 2020, right? So there are some free classes which we will be having in the upcoming week. Mains 2020 current affairs, also some of the free classes I will be conducting for all of you. These are the people who are appearing in the interview from our different courses. We are also running the daily answer writing courses. You can take the advantage. Great. So now